Hello everyone, I'm Chad Smith, and today we're going to continue to talk about simplicity alarming. Part 2, we'll talk about some advanced point alarm concepts, specifically the different types of alarms that you can configure in simplicity. So if I go back to our temperature point, initially we just had a simple set of limits that we were checking against. If you hit the advanced key, you'll see that there's a number of other options that are available. Today we're going to talk about the options in this area here, specifically the different types of alarms. So we talked about absolute alarms in the initial demonstration, which basically alarms a point whenever it is outside or above or below these ranges. So you can see in the runtime that we have our alarm currently in a high alarm state because it's above 28 and below 35. So that is your absolute alarm limits that it checks to see if it's within those ranges. Next in the list is called absolute equals. This is very similar, just that the only difference being that it checks for the exact value in these limits and uses that to put it in or out of alarm. So you can see if I hit apply now, that alarm over here, which was in alarm because it was above 28 and below 35, is now not in alarm because 30 degrees isn't exactly 28 or 35. So it's in normal state. So if I select that alarm and acknowledge it, it'll go out of alarm. But if I specifically say my value is minus 5, you can see it'll go into the low state because that exactly matches minus 5. Same thing if I go down to minus 20, it's in low. But if I go to minus 8, that's not an alarm, that's normal, and that's can be taken out of alarm. So that is absolute equals alarm. Next, we're going to skip down to the on update alarm, which is again a very simple alarm. In this case, you do not even need any limits because essentially you will have an alarm whenever the value changes. So you can see it is currently in a normal state over here because we switched into that alarm type. But normally that's not an alarm until it changes. So if I change this now to 20 degrees, it keeps a state of normal, but it basically says you had a value that changed and now you need to acknowledge that. It'll go back and that'll go away. But every time you change it, it will actually trigger another alarm. So again, simple on update. Every time it changes, you get an alarm. The next type of alarm that we'll talk about is the deviation alarm. You can see if you look at the tooltip, deviation alarms basically detect when an alarm deviates too far from a given value specified in a different point. So to work with deviation alarms, you normally wouldn't work with negative numbers. So we'll just simplify this a little bit and we'll say, we want to say if an alarm deviates by 10, then we want to go into an alarm. So in this case, we need to specify an actual point. So we're going to create a new virtual point called the deviation point, simple enough. And we'll say that its value will start out as, let's say, 10. So anything, the difference between the current value of our point from 10, if it's greater than 10, then it will be a deviation. So let's apply that. You can see that, acknowledge that. So we don't have an alarm right now. Currently we're at 15. So if we, and our deviation point is at 10. So if we go to 25, our deviation will be 15. And that will put us in a deviation alarm situation where we differ from the deviation point by more than the value of the deviation point. So if you look at the deviation point in the database, you'll see we set it to 10. So when we go outside of the range of the difference between our point and the deviation point by whatever limits are here, we'll get a deviation alarm. Finally, we'll talk about probably the most, maybe the most complex type of alarm, which is rate of change alarm. So if you look at when you switch to rate of change, it gives you a new field called interval. If you look at the tooltip, you'll see that this indicates how often I should check to see if the value has changed more than an alarm limit. So I would suggest that you go to the help and go to the alarm criteria rate of change alarm. Just to it gives you a good table showing you how it detects rate of change. So in our case, what we'll do is we'll say that if a value goes up by 10, more than 10, then that's a rate of change alarm, or down faster, more than 10, that will be a rate of change alarm for us. Now, you have the minimum change or interval rate that you can specify is 5. We're going to say 10 for our case, and we'll apply that. So you can see that it was originally high, but now 10 seconds went by and it realized that the value hadn't changed from 21 to anything else, so the rate of change was 0. If I were to indicate 33 here, and then the 10 second interval will come up, we'll see that it will detect that we went up by more than the rate of change. See, high. Now if I go back down to, let's say, 5, the next time 10 seconds comes up, it'll realize that I've changed down by more than 10, so I get the high case because we went in the negative direction. That's rate of change. So that's just a quick look at the different alarm types offered by CIMPLICITY. In subsequent videos, we'll talk about the other advanced settings in this tab.